In today's video, I wanted to talk about violence. And not because I'm a fan of violence, it's actually quite the opposite. I don't like violence. Hey guys, welcome back to Life Up Education TV. I'm your host Natsune, and also the author of the book called The Game of Self-Domination. Okay, in today's video, I wanted to talk about violence. And not because I'm a fan of violence, it's actually quite the opposite. I don't like violence. In today's video, I wanted to talk about violence. And not because I'm a fan of violence, it's actually quite the opposite. I don't like violence. Recently, maybe some of you have already saw that I've been obsessively watching Criminal Minds, and which means that I had this like intense opportunity thinking about why do violence happen? Like what, like how can we decrease it, right? And I wanted to talk about that, why I feel authentically about it. So I picked three things to talk about in this video today. So let's talk about it. Okay, the first thing I wanted to address is violence and fear do not equal respect. And that is because, you know, the gun, like when you want someone to basically obey you, the instant, the most immediate method you can use is putting a gun onto their head or putting a gun to them, right? And then you gain instant respect. But this respect is not a good kind of respect, because it's not necessarily even a respect, it's a threat, right? Like they are scared for their life, and they're not doing things because they want to do it, they're doing it because they're forced. And I think the way I define the ultimate sin, I describe in another video, I say the ultimate sin is taking someone's free will. So it's actually simple behavior than being respected. And as sad as it sounds, yeah, yes, I believe that everything does have its own like space. Maybe sometimes violence is necessary, but never to the intention to like hurt someone. Hopefully, maybe I'm being too naive or romantic. But yeah, at least like, the starting point is from this one. Like, you need to understand that just because you are scaring someone, like, that doesn't mean that you're earning their respect, right? And I think a lot of people, in a sense, do this. Like, a lot of people are guilty of using violence in the mean of, like, earning respect. And another thing I talk about is, like, never expect someone to respect you just because of your status, just because everything you've achieved. But expect someone to respect you because you treat them with respect. So I think this is a very important concept, because rather than flexing on your egoism, like rather than flexing on like what you have achieved, like your ego, you should flex on like how much you can do for others, and then in return you can perhaps expect respect back from that person. But never come in with your impressive resume and be like, respect me. No, that's not how it works, and it shouldn't be how it works, because then the world will be just a bunch of like very selfish fuckers expecting people to give them just because they achieved, right? So yeah, for the sake of making the world a little bit better and kinder place, like, let's stop that trend and let's start treating people with respect, and in return you get respect. So it's not out of necessity, but it's out of like actual willingness from their end. Okay, the next one I wanted to talk about, so why do violence happen? I wanted to talk about that, and here I searched why that is, and I found this like science paper, whatever, that talks about that. Okay, let me play music before I move on. It's a Christmas song, but I love it, so I'm gonna play it anyway. Okay, it says the most common motivation for violence. The most common motivations for violence can be viewed as inappropriate attempts to handle emotions. So that's the first reason. Often violence is the medium used by individuals to openly express their feelings, such as anger, frustration, or sadness. Other times, violence can be considered as a form of manipulation for individuals to try and get what they want or need. So basically, right, like pointing the gun at someone to love someone, right? Aggressive behavior can also be used as a form of retaliation, a mean by which one uses to even the scores. Finally, violence behavior is sometimes caused because people grow up seeing violence openly displayed. So that's the third reason. And the first two, so basically mismanaging your emotion, trying to use violence in the mean of like earning respect or manipulation, sounds a little bit more manageable within your mindset. But in the end of the day, everything comes down to mindset, because look at Oprah. Like she was molested and she lost her child when she was like 14 years old or something like that. She still managed to be one of the most like successful media personality in America, right? Like there's examples after examples out there who regardless of their reasons, regardless of their hard background, like they came to the other side and they decided intentionally to pursue story of inspiration versus story of victimization, right? So to circling back to the point, the third reason why it happens is because like violence behavior displayed openly, like you have two options here. You can decide, because this happens, it's okay for you to do it, versus like, because it happens, I'm gonna make sure the same pain, like people don't have to go through the same pain. And it's just better to choose the latter, because it's at that time, there's no longer suffering, because you're not making it about you, but you're making it about like how you can use your experience, which is super valuable, because that's super not like true to you, right? Experience that no one has experienced other than you, your specific experience, and to decide that, use that experience to be helpful for others, right? So that's what I want to say. And then the first two, coming back to the first two, mismanaging emotion and manipulation, I think it comes down to more of like you need to understand that it's under your control and it can be fixed by mindset more. Like, just try to do good for the society. Don't be so selfish. Like, try to be good part of the member, like part of member of the society, right? So that's the manipulation part. You can fight against that. And then the first, very first one, mismanaging emotion. I think. All of these three comes down to you obsessing over you, like you're suffering, right? But emotion happens because you feel like all it matters right now in that picture is you, and you're completely ignoring other people in that picture. But you just need to know that the world is never about you individually, like you individual, like specifically. But you also need to know that it's okay to take it less seriously, because the world is never about you. It's always about the world, like the bigger picture, the entire picture. So that would be my advice. I feel like I could probably talk more about it. So I'm gonna probably try to make another video specifically focusing on this topic later, but I'm gonna move on for the sake of time for now. Okay, the third one I wanted to talk about is, if I hadn't lost my hearing, I wouldn't be where I am now. It forced me to maximize my own potential. I have to be better than the average person to succeed. And I love this person's tweet. It's like raising your standard, right? I often tell people and tell myself that you need to find a story to raise your standard. And instead of letting that reason, that whatever you don't have as disadvantage, that big enough reason for you to not even try or quit, like this person went out of their way to find that inspiration inside of her story and say, I don't have this, but I can still succeed. And for me to succeed, furthermore, I need to raise my standard. And this is amazing. I think that's how you should look at it. Whenever you encounter any sort of like scarcity, you need to remember that your disadvantage is actually advantage, because you can stay sharp, you can stay ambitious, you can actually use that as a reason to strive, right? And not everybody gets to have it, so enjoy having that, right? Okay, so this was the end of the video. I'm gonna close it because it's like 10 minutes. But thank you very much for watching, you guys, and I will see you guys in the next video.